So this is your seventh knockout win that you've had in your pro career. How does it feel to come into the UFC and make that kind of impression right away?
It feels great. I mean, basically it feels like I belong here. I've been telling myself over and over that I belong here. Came up short and on the show, but I just got back, started training hard, and worked on a lot of things that helped me tonight. So it feels real good to debut in that sort of, and have a showing like that.
You've been classically known as a boxer, yet we saw a lot of different aspects of your overall game in this fight. What have you specifically been working on since the show?
Oh, since the show, I've been working on my wrestling, working with Penn State alumni John Liberanti, and it's been great. Also working with Brian Stanton and then my team, X3 Sports, and Tony Tucci and 185, but we've put together a well-oiled machine between all of us. So I'm just want to keep moving forward and keep working my way up.
Was it difficult for you only having 10 days to prepare for a new opponent? Because originally I'm assuming you were supposed to face Zach Cummings, and then we had Bristol Maroon Day come in for you.
Fighting is mental, so if you overthink stuff and put a lot of pressure on yourself, you're going to go out there with too many worries on your head. So they switched my opponent. I was happy to get a fight, and I just said I'm going to come out here and let my hands go. Didn't let them go the way I wanted to, but I have more to work on and just keep pushing forward.
You said you learned a lot of little things in the tough house. Can you tell us about, you know, what little things you picked up that, you know, maybe that you didn't learn working with Brian Stan?
Little thing that I picked up in the house was how today when I wanted to get up, I got wrist control, pushed the wrist over, and just kind of did a technical stance. So me and my coach Tony Tucci and over at X3 Sports, we've been working on that a lot and getting everything together and just dialing in on the small things.
And yeah, you were a pro boxer back in 2007. You walked away because you didn't feel like you were getting enough matches, I believe. Do you see more opportunities in MMA now that you've been here a while?
I was still getting matches, but I just looked at it as I was good at MMA. It was kind of like a fresh start. I mean, my last boxing match was just last year. It was less than a year ago. So I just stayed active just to stay busy and not get built up in the ring rush because I was trying to build my record and get to the UFC. And I made a path with my management team and my coaches and made that strategic plan, and finally I've made it here.
Did you feel any added pressure being the number one overall pick, you know, and not making the finale, coming out here tonight wanting to make an impression?
I don't know, overall pressure. I never put any pressure on myself like that. This is what I do. I love what I do. I come out to fight, and I come out to entertain. I'm an entertainer as well as a fighter at the end of the day.
You had Bristol hurt a couple times. Talk about not being able to finish him through the first and second rounds. Were you discouraged? Were you surprised that he was able to persevere through some of those shots that you were hitting him with?
Oh, no, I wasn't discouraged at all. Coming in, I knew he had a good chin. I knew he was going to be able to take my shots. But if he takes one, he's going to have to take two. He's going to have to take three. And eventually, you start chopping. You take a tree and chop it at the base. It's eventually going to fall. So I just kept trying to chop, and then seeing the opening and exploited it.
Talk about the technique that finishes the fight, a standing elbow, something that we don't see often in MMA. We don't see a clean one stop a fight, just one strike. Was that something you were setting up, or is that just something you throw and hope it lands?
No, it's never anything that I throw. I seen the opening on when he was striked, so and then we worked on it the last couple of days, just getting an arc on it and throwing it from over top. And I seen the opening, and I just kind of was patient. But when I wasn't able to finish him, that was more on my part. I wasn't able to put together. I couldn't find the angles to get my shots in there, so I just stayed patient and knew eventually I was gonna finish him.
When the elbow landed, did you know it was done?
I was getting ready to jump on him. I mean, I never know it's done until the ref stops me. That's just the sport that we live in.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Thanks.